हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू बायोलॉजी क्लास। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक एयर बोर्न, ओके, वाटर बोर्न एंड फूड बोर्न डिजीजेस फ्रॉम चैप्टर 4th, दैट इज हेल्थ एंड हाइजीन। एंड दिस टॉपिक इज फ्रॉम क्लास 6। सो ऑलरेडी यू नो दैट कम्युनिकेबल डिजीजेस आर द डिजीजेस विच गेट ट्रांसमिटेड फ्रॉम one person to another person. So you have gone through different ways like direct mode and indirect mode of transmission of diseases. Then we have discussed regarding vector bone, okay, and in today's lecture we are going to discuss the diseases which spread through air, which spread through water, and which spread through food. Now when we talk about this first disease, that is airborne, it means in this the air plays an important role in transmission of disease. Okay, so how airborne diseases they spread? Basically, you know, bacteria and viruses, these are present in the air. Now when an infected person, okay, suppose this person A is infected, when this infected person coughs, sneezes, speaks or spit, जब वो infected person खांसता है, थूकता है, ठीक है, बोलता है या छींक मारता है, at that time the droplets they get released from the mouth or the nose of the infected person. And the virus or the bacteria present in that, it get transmitted through air into the body of healthy person. So when these bacteria and viruses they enter the body of healthy person, they makes the person infected. Okay, so basically the air is helping in transmission. Due to air, these viruses and these bacteria they spread quickly. Okay, so for example, common cold. Okay, it is airborne disease. It spreads very quickly. Now, common cold, it is a viral infection. Okay, and the virus of this common cold, it spreads quickly when it is present in the air. Then whooping cough, okay, and tuberculosis. So these common cold, whooping cough, and tuberculosis, these are the example of airborne disease. Next disease is bitter water borne. Means these diseases they occur from water, means the source of these diseases is water. So whenever we are consuming or we are drinking contaminated or polluted water, the germs present in that water enters into our body and they make us diseased. Okay, so basically water bodies they get polluted or they get contaminated by four main ways. So first is domestic sewage, the waste which is generated in our house, when it enters the water bodies, it pollutes the water and it makes the water dirty. And when this dirty water or the contaminated water, it enters the body of the person, the germs, they make the person diseased. Second is industrial waste. Industries produce lot of waste and this waste contains lot of chemicals which are not good for the health. So when the waste of the industries it is released to water bodies, lot of chemicals it enters, it mix into the water body and makes that water unfit. Okay, and if by mistake we drink that water or animals drink that water, these chemicals they make us diseased. Third is
excretion of infected person. Now, suppose if an infected person defecates in the open area, the waste it contains lot of germs, and if rain happens, the rainwater it will take away all these germs from the waste, and that water will mix with main water bodies, and the germs from the excreta of the infected person it will mix into the water and will make the water contaminated. Okay, okay. So the next source for the diseases is food, means the diseases which arise by consuming contaminated food. Okay, so there are various diseases like cholera, typhoid, okay, diarrhea. All these diseases they occur by consumption of dirty food or contaminated food. This cholera, diarrhea, typhoid, it also happens when we drink contaminated water. Now, you should never consume the cut or exposed food item. The food item like fruits and vegetables which are exposed to lot of dust particles, lot of germs, okay, they are present on these articles, and when these articles are eaten by the human being, the germs they enter into the body and they make the person diseased. Okay, second is flavoring agent. Flavoring agent or coloring agent, so these are the chemicals which are added in the ice creams and syrups. So these chemicals which are present in this ice cream and syrups, these are harmful for the body. Okay, they will make us ill or they will make us diseased. So you keep in mind that whenever you are consuming the fruit or whenever you are taking vegetables, you have to properly wash them, otherwise the germs on these substances they will enter the body and they will make us diseased.